Bulldogs. We're out here again. I'm with the kids, and we understand how disappointing it is that we haven't been able to start our baseball season. So today's activity is going to have to do with baseball. We're going to do a little bit of throwing and some pitching. And then at the end, we have a game that we're going to have where you can either go against the clock or you can go against your brother, your sister, your mother or father. In our case, we're going to have Lauren and John going against each other. All right, so we're going to start off, even though we're outside right now, this is a game that we've designed that you could do inside as well. So instead of using a real ball, we've made a sock ball. So this ball should be good to use outdoors and to use indoors, and you won't be breaking any of Mom's vases or glasses or lamps, okay? So we took some socks, we bunched them together, and we made a sock ball. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna be getting a little bit of cardio in with our throws. So we have John and Lauren here. So we're gonna stand about this far away. You can use the wall inside. We're gonna use the garage here. And you're gonna warm your arm up by, she's gonna throw the ball. It's gonna hit the wall. She's gonna sprint as fast as she can. She's gonna get it. She's gonna run it back. She's gonna give it to John, and John's gonna do the same thing. We'll do that for about 2 or 3 minutes. All right? So here we go. Go ahead, Lauren, when you're ready. Get it, run it back. John's gonna get ready. Try to go as fast as you can. Come on. The ball falls apart, we just put it back together. Step and throw, good. Orientation, stepping with the opposite foot, bringing the ball over their head, releasing it out in front of them, and aiming where they want the ball to go. We'll do this for about 30 more seconds. Your target, all right? And then we're gonna take, I'm gonna use cones here. You can use shoes, you can use anything to mark where you're gonna be throwing from. So, put one here, and one here. Now the object of the game is, you're gonna take the ball. You're trying to get three outs by striking out. Start at the clothesline. And when they say go, you're gonna flow. Get the ball into, get it inside of the basket. That counts as one strike. Then you're gonna come back to the start's first spot again. That would be two strikes. I come back, then I'm gonna go for the basket a third time. If I get it the third time, then that's one out. Strike three. Once I get one out, then I'm gonna come back to the second spot. Okay, it's gonna get a little harder now. So let's say I throw one and I miss. That does not count as a strike. So I need to get it, come back. Once I get three strikes and a second out from the second spot, then I'm gonna move to the third spot. Throw, trying to get three outs, okay? Now there's two ways you can do this. You can either set a timer see how quickly you can do it, and then see if the person you're going against can do it quicker, or you can count total number of pitches by the time they're done. So we're going to get started. Don's going to go first. So Don's going to start up here, and I'm going to be the counter. So we're going to start in front on three. One, two, three, go. There's one strike. Gotta go play the race. Up, he missed, so it's still one strike. That's two pitches. Two strikes. All right, he got all three of them in. That's one out. Now he's going back to the next one. He's on four pitches. Strike one. Miss. Still one strike from the second spot. Two strikes. And three strikes. So that's two outs. He's going back to the last one now. He's missed two times so far. There's one strike. Two outs, one strike. Two strikes. All right, he's got one more strike, and he struck out the side. Still needs one more. He's missed four times. Oh, he's missed five times. He still needs one more strike. I think he might be getting tired. Missed six times. He still needs one more strike. And he gets his strike three. Alright, so John missed six times. So now Lauren's gonna go and she's gonna see if she can miss six times or less. Alright, let's see it. One, and there's one strike. Two strikes. Three strikes. We need to see good form on your throws, kids. Remember, side orientation. Step with the opposite foot. One strike. Lauren hasn't missed yet. Up her first miss. She's got one strike from the second. One out. One strike. Two strikes from the second line. She's only missed once. Now she's missed twice. Strikes from the second line. Three strikes. That's two outs. She's going back to the last one. She's only missed twice. One strike. Nope, she missed. That's three misses. Uh-oh, it's going to be a close game here. She needs two more strikes. Five misses. Oh no, she's falling apart on the last one. Six misses. She can't miss again or John is the winner. All right, she got two strikes. Can she get the third out? And she missed her last one. So, the game would end, and since John missed six times and Lauren missed seven before she got three out, John would be the winner. All right, so we hope you guys have some fun with this game, and we will see you next time.